Welcome to Optical Fiber Communication Playlist. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you OADM, Optical Add-Drop Multiplexer, in this session. So this session is all about Optical Add-Drop Multiplexer. And to have this session, these are my session outlines, where first I'm going to explain you basics of OADM. Then after, I'll explain you different types of OADM. So here there are total four different types of OADM that I'll be going to explain you with its working. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of OADM. Now see, OADM means what? It is optical add-drop multiplexer. So optical add-drop multiplexer, that we are using it to add or drop any wavelength in between network. So in case of, if you need to add some signal in between network, then by using this we can have it. Or in some cases there are receivers which want to receive particular wavelength in between network, then even we can use this OADM in between network to take wavelength or to add wavelength. See, in some applications it is required to add some wavelength or to drop wavelength. Depending on requirements, we use OADM. See, we are performing this task by using OADM of adding and dropping wavelength. By using OADM, we reduces complexity of connection in between transmitter and receiver. Basically, when you establish connection in between transmitter and receiver, there are some routing algorithm. And if you don't have OADM in network, in that case, those complexity of routing algorithm will be very high. So to reduce complexity of connection establishment in between transmitter and receiver, we use OADM. OADM also increases network capacity. Why? The reason is, in between network we can connect more nodes, or one can say more terminals, as well as we can receive signal in between network. So by having OADM, we increases more number of connection in network. So by having OADM, we increase network capacity. Now let us see the different types which is there with OADM. So commonly used architectures of OADM are given below. So there are four different architectures which is there with OADM. One is parallel OADM, second is modular version of parallel, third is serial OADM, and fourth is band drop OADM. We will see all four OADM in detail. So let us see first OADM, that is parallel OADM. Now see, in parallel OADM, here we have lambda 1 to lambda n number of wavelengths, and here even we have lambda 1 to lambda n number of wavelengths. But if you observe, see, this wavelengths that is getting separated by having demultiplexer. So this demultiplexer will separate out all the wavelengths. So here lambda 1 to lambda n wavelength, you can see that is getting separated. Now here in parallel OADM, we are dropping lambda 1 and lambda 2 wavelength for this particular case. And we are adding lambda 1 dash and lambda 2 dash wavelength. And then again, it is given to multiplexer, which will combine all wavelengths and it will give it on this fiber. So basically, in parallel OADM, we can have multiple wavelengths that we can add and we can drop by having this parallel OADM. So if you see the working, see, initially all incoming wavelengths, that is lambda 1 to lambda n, that has been given to demultiplexer, and that will generate separate output wavelengths from lambda 1 to lambda n. So you can see it over here, lambda 1 to lambda n wavelengths are separated, and out of that separated wavelength we can take, means we can drop wavelengths as per requirement. So here lambda 1 and lambda 2 wavelength, that is getting dropped over here. Some wavelengths are dropped at this stage and other wavelengths are passed through multiplexer. So you can see other wavelengths other than lambda 1 and lambda 2, we are passing it to multiplexer, as well as we are adding additional two wavelengths, lambda 1 dash and lambda 2 dash. So at multiplexer, other wavelengths like lambda 1 dash and lambda 2 dash also can be added. So you can see multiple wavelengths, that is what we are multiplexing over here, and that we are passing it on optical fiber. So in parallel OADM, we take parallel wavelengths to get dropped over here, as well as we can add it in between network, right? In the market, there are multiple types of parallel OADM which is available. Here I have explained the case for two wavelength parallel OADM, but in market for higher complexity, there are four wavelength OADM is available, where you can add four wavelength as well as you can draw four wavelength, as well as there are 8 channel parallel OADM, 16 channel parallel OADM is available. So based on the need, one can prefer parallel OADM in the network. Now let us see second type of OADM, and that is modular version of OADM. Now in modular version of OADM, we do multiplexing and demultiplexing at two level. So you can see here one demultiplexer is connected, and here second demultiplexer is connected. And for multiplexing, here you can see one multiplexer, that is major multiplexer, which we have connected here, and second multiplexer that we have connected here. Now see, here we have lambda 1 to lambda n wavelengths, which is what we are having it on fiber. After that, there is demultiplexer. This demultiplexer is demultiplexing this wavelengths in terms of band. Now one should understand there is a difference in between wavelength and band. Band is a bunch of wavelength. So here these wavelengths are demultiplexed in terms of bunch, that is referred as band. So here band 1, band 2, band 3, that is how that is getting demultiplexed. And one more band which is over here, that we have demultiplexed, and again we are demultiplexing it and we are dropping it. So here there will be band, but here there will be wavelengths. So here we are dropping few wavelengths after having demultiplexing of band. Now if you have some wavelengths which you need to add it in network, then this wavelengths that is getting combined by this multiplexer, so that will convert that into band. So here there will be band, and multiple bands that is getting again combined by this multiplexer, and multiple wavelengths that will be there on this fiber. So in modular version of OADM, there is multi-stage multiplexing and demultiplexing, and this type of modular version of OADM that we are using it in dense wavelength division multiplexing, where we need to have more number of channel to be added and more number of channel to be dropped. So in that scenario, we should be using this modular version of OADM. See, in this type of OADM, mux and demux operation that is happening at two level, right? So there are two stages. You can see we have done it at two stages. In first stage, it is done at band level, and in second stage, it is done at channel level, or one can say wavelength level. So here in band, we have combination of wavelengths, and after second level, we will be having channels, right? So channels are dropped and added after having second stage. And this is what we are using it in DWDM network. DWDM means what? Dense wavelength division multiplexing. So if your network is very dense in terms of wavelength, means wavelengths are separated at very small distance, right? So wavelengths are very dense, they are very near to each other. In that case, we should be using modular version of OADM. So for higher capacity of network, we should be using modular version of OADM. Let us see third type of OADM, that is serial OADM. Now if you observe, as per name indicates, in serial OADM, we are connecting OADM in series, you can see. So this is module 1 and this is module 2. Here we have optical cable that is carrying wavelength lambda 1 to lambda n, and here by having one module, we are dropping one wavelength and we are adding one wavelength, and they are connected in series. So by having more number of series element, we can increase more number of dropping capability of wavelength, and we can add more number of wavelength by connecting more number of modules. So in series means serial OADM, we are having elements are connected in series, and as per requirement we can drop and we can add wavelength as per number of modules which we have connected over here. See, this architecture can drop single channel at a time, and it is also referred as SOADM. So one should know, if it is there as per SOADM, then this is what serial OADM, in that modules are connected in series and it is having capability of dropping and adding wavelength by one channel. If it is required to add and drop multiple channels at a time, then number of architectures are connected in series. So if you want to increase capability, then you should be connecting more number of elements in series so that you can add and drop more number of channels in the network. So serial OADM, that one can have in case of there is a requirement of flexible need, like you don't need extra cabling, and based on the need one can connect serial OADM, means in series one can connect OADM so that they can have more number of channels. Let us have last OADM, that is band drop OADM. Now if you see this band drop OADM structure, then here we are not dropping wavelengths, here we are dropping band. So here you can see lambda 1 to lambda n wavelengths that is coming to this OADM, and lambda 1 to lambda n wavelengths that is again floated on the optical fiber, right? So here we are dropping band and we are adding band. So here in terms of band we are doing things. What is band? Band is group of wavelength, or one can say group of channels. So group of channels or group of wavelengths that could be added and that could be dropped in case of band drop OADM. So this OADM is used to drop and add band of wavelengths. So combination of band that we are dropping and adding by using this, where in single band there could be multiple channels, or one can say multiple wavelengths. See, from the total set of channels, a fixed group of channels is added or dropped. So there is fixed group of channels that we are dealing with to drop and that we are dealing with to add. So this facility is there. And when you drop multiple channels in terms of band, further demultiplexing is required. So here whatever band drop that you are having, that is there in terms of band. So again, to take out channels, further demultiplexing is required. So after band drop, one should provide demultiplexing operation over here, and then you can have separate channels and that one can give it to respected receivers. And here in case of band add, there will be multiple channels which is coming over here, and that we are dealing with to add, and that addition of channels, that we do it by having couplers. So couplers will combine multiple channels and that will be given to band add. So existing fiber will be having multiple channels, and here we are adding it by having band addition. But one should understand this, that band addition, that one can have it by having multiplexer, or they can have couplers where couplers is combining multiple wavelengths over here. So this is all about band drop OADM. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions, and you can download all this material which I'm teaching here free of cost from my channel application Engineering Funda. You can see the link which is given in description of all videos. Download that application. You can download material free of cost which I'm teaching here from that, and you just give your valuable suggestions. The reason is your suggestions are most welcome to me, and that gives me motivation to work out for students. Thank you so much for watching this.